هيا على الفلاح.
Assalamu alaikum. Are we allowed to disagree with our parents or our elders? Well, the Quran teaches us to be kind to our parents, and the Quran teaches us to be kind to adults, those who are older than us, to respect them and to listen to them. But definitely, if they are wrong, we should not agree with them. When you know that your parent is wrong, you do not agree with something you know is wrong. So you are allowed to disagree with your parents. You're allowed to disagree with the elders. You're allowed to disagree with your teachers. You're allowed to disagree with your mentors. We're all human beings and we all can make mistakes. So if there is a mistake or something wrong, something in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you notice, you cannot just agree with it, because in that particular case, you will be responsible in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having agreed with something that is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So many times people say, well, look, that's your father, just listen to him, or that's your mother, or that's an older person, or that's your teacher, that's your ustad, or that's a sheikh, etc. To be honest with you, they are human beings. That's what we should realize. And yes, when it comes to Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we do not disagree with anything. We agree with everything they've brought, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, the nourisher, the cherisher. He is the decider. He is the one who lays the rules and regulations. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam totally protected from error, mistakes, blunder, etc. So we obey everything. And Allah mentions this in the Quran, that it is not befitting for a believing male or female that when Allah and His Messenger have declared something, that they feel they still have an option about it. But when it comes to your fathers, your mothers, your brothers, the older people, like I said, your teachers, your sheikhs, the imam, whoever else it may be, you will disagree with them in certain things when they are wrong. Some you may disagree with them more often or in more things, and some in less things. Some you may not pick up any disagreement. But you need to know where they are wrong, they are wrong. One of the weaknesses of mankind is we tend to look up to people sometimes in a way that we put them on a pedestal such that they can never make mistakes. And if they do make mistakes, it doesn't mean, my brothers and sisters, that we hate them, we dislike them, or we're disrespecting them. To me, the greatest disrespect is actually when you know someone is doing something wrong and you cheer them on. That is great disrespect. It shows that you don't care for them, you don't love them, and actually you don't respect them. So, once again, are we allowed to disagree with our parents? The answer is when and if they are wrong, yes, you're allowed to disagree. Not only allowed, you have to. Ibrahim alayhi salam disagreed with his father completely. And in fact, his father warned him and threatened him, and he still disagreed because it was a major issue. It was something to do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and faith in Allah. And so, my beloved brothers and sisters, the main thing you need to remember is be polite, be kind, don't be disrespectful, but you can disagree with respect. This is why I say, and we all hear many times, people say that, you know what, with all due respect, I disagree, or I respectfully disagree. That's what it is. There is no need to be impolite, to be abusive. In fact, it's haram and prohibited to be vulgar, to be hurtful, and to choose words that are very, very harmful, hurtful, etc. But when we disagree, we do so for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a beautiful way. You can disagree with your mother as well. She can be wrong and she can be corrected. This is something that many people feel, that's my mother, I can't say anything. That's my father, that's my sheikh, that's the imam, that's a scholar, etc. You can correct them very respectfully. You can disagree, and in fact, they would, if they were genuine, appreciate correction. So this was just a clarificationary video in order to explain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked us to do the right thing and to stay away from the wrong thing and to guide people towards goodness. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam disagreed with a lot of the elders of Quraysh, and not only that, many of them were his own uncles and they were from his own family. In fact, if you look at Abu Talib, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continued to remind him, but very politely, to worship Allah alone, and many other factors. Now, when it comes to petty disagreements, we can stay away from those. We don't need to disagree for minor things. When it comes to matters of importance, matters of justice, matters where you know that this is wrong, sometimes there is a trait that needs correction, sometimes your father gets very angry, your mother becomes very vulgar, she needs to be told, "My beloved mother, I love you so much, I care for you, but your swearing, your abuse, your hurt, your hate is unacceptable, not only in the eyes of Allah, but it's going to create a problem between us too. Because a day will come when we won't be able to live with you anymore because of the way you're using your tongue. So learn to speak respectfully and kindly as well. As much as we're taught to be respectful to those older than us, we're also taught that we should be merciful towards those who are younger than us. That doesn't mean we should disrespect them, but it's more the point that we should be concentrating on. Amazing teachings of Islam, my brothers and sisters. While we acknowledge the seniority of people, we have to understand where they are wrong. They need to be told in a very respectful way if needed. And at the same time, we should understand we should disagree with that which is wrong in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless every one of us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us beautiful homes. May we be parents who can take from our children correction. And may we be from among those whom, no matter how old we are, we can actually take correction from those who are younger than us. When they disagree with us, we don't feel bad, we don't feel hurt, and we don't blackmail them by telling them, "I'm older than you, you have to listen to me, I'm your father, you have to obey instructions, heaven lies at my service or at my feet," or whatever else people say in order to blackmail their children into submission, even when they are wrong. Remember, we cannot say heaven lies at the feet of the mother if that particular mother herself is heading towards a place besides heaven. So that's something very interesting and important if you were to think about it. May Allah grant us all Jannatul Firdaus. Aqulu qawli hadha. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you so much for listening to this short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope. And the same applies to all of us. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.